Hello and welcome to a very special episode of Beyond the Campfire. This is my 1,000 subscriber special. And today I've got something a little bit different in store for you. First of all, though, I want to apologize for the terrible quality of just about everything going on right now. The video quality, the audio quality. I just messed around with the software for at least an hour, and I'm very frustrated with it, and this is the best we're going to get for now. If I ever do something like this again, I'll try to do a better job. Anyway, like I said, this is the 1,000 subscriber special, and today we're going to be watching a previously unreleased video. This is my first ever backpacking video that has never been revealed to the public before, and you'll probably figure out why pretty quickly, because it's not very good. Well, before we get started, thank you, everybody. Thank you for subscribing. I really appreciate hitting this milestone. I appreciate every single person who's taken time out of their day to watch my stuff and help me get here. So thank you. And this is a little something for you that's hopefully semi-entertaining, at least. So this video, let me get my face out of the way. This video was shot 6 years ago, 2017, in Zaleski State Forest. That's near Hocking Hills, for anybody who knows where that is. This was a couple years into my backpacking career, but still kind of the early days. I'd done maybe like 8 to 10 trips before this one. So, and they were all like overnighters that were probably less than 15 miles, which is what this one is. This is an overnight trip, about 15 miles. So they were all kind of like this beforehand. No mountains, no through hikes or anything up to this point. So this is still pretty early on, and this also predates my channel by about a year. So the earliest video on my actual channel right now was from 2018. So this is a little. This is the very first. This is episode zero of Beyond the Campfire. So crack open a drink and let's watch this thing.
Well, here we are at Zaleski State Forest. We are at the Hope Schoolhouse parking lot. There aren't very many people here, which is good. This is Memorial Day, after all. I was expecting there to be more people here. It's about 11:30. I was a little bit late getting here because I kind of took a wrong turn. There's all my crap. I'm gonna hurry up and finish this bagel with peanut butter, and then I'm gonna get on the trail. Well, I'm all geared up and I think I'm ready to go. I think.
Okay, right away we notice there's a bunch of terrible wind noise. That is one of the reasons why I wanted to get a nice microphone for my camera. That's why I now use this thing on my camera microphone, because I hate all that wind noise that just kind of blows out the audio and you can't hear anything I'm saying. Also, you'll notice that the image, the video quality is pretty terrible. This was shot on a Canon point-and-shoot camera in 720p, so do not adjust the resolution on your screen. It's not your screen, it's mine. And actually, the first two videos on my channel, my actual channel, were also shot with that little Canon. But for some reason, this video in particular looks worse than those.
Trail doesn't really give you any time to warm up, that's for sure. Right after the parking lot, I crossed the road I came in on, and then straight uphill. I'm sweating already.
So that wasn't in very good shape.
I said that this is probably the lightest backpack I've ever carried on an overnighter. I sure doesn't feel like it now.
I do think this was maybe my last trip before I bought a much lighter backpack. As you can see, I'm wearing that huge 70-ish liter Kelty backpack that still occasionally makes an appearance on the channel. Actually, the next video I release, it's going to have that backpack in it again. But man, that thing weighs like 5 pounds and just feels like something riding you. It's huge. It's got all these straps hanging off of it. It is not a not a lightweight, not an ultralight piece of gear at all. You can also see I have that. I'm using a water bladder in my backpack, which I also don't do that anymore. And I guess if anybody wants to know why, it's the reason I switched from using that water bladder to using like the water bottles in the side pockets. Two reasons. The biggest one is that you can't tell how much water is in your bladder, really. You never really know when you need to fill up and when you don't. And the second reason is that it's just a pain to get in and out of your backpack. You have to take out half the stuff that's in your backpack to get it out. And then it's even more of a disincentive to sit down and filter water because you don't feel like hauling half your gear out and then having to pack it back in. So I've really just moved away from those and to the water bottles.
Maybe I should have bought that new backpack this weekend.
Yeah, you should have.
But anyway, it's nice out here. I was a little worried that this trail was going to be like the Shawnee State Forest backpacking trail, which I did exactly a year ago, Memorial Day last year. And that trail was just brutal. I had a miserable time on that trail.
And I've never been back. Already.
I like this.
Oh no, oh no, hold on, hold on. Alright, so I think the main reason that I'm even recording this video right now is because our friend over at Bluegrass Backcountry requested this. I showed this to him maybe a year ago, and ever since then he has been trying to get me to make this public. And I think the biggest reason is because he found this particular scene so funny. And I do too. Also, I need to talk over this because there's copyrighted music in here, and I'm trying to avoid a copyright strike on this. But just check out the manual map sequence that I decided to do because I don't know why I decided to do it this way. But just look at this and enjoy all of its glory. The picture in picture hand-drawn map sequence.
I made it to the first intersection. I take a left. It takes me to the north loop and the west loop. If I go this way to the right, it's going to take me along the south loop where there are two campgrounds. I think I'm going to try this one just in case I get tired. I want to quit early. I'm at point B right now. There's water at point C, camp at point D, and there's just under a mile before I get there. But I'm gonna head that way, and I think that'll be a nice little place to stop for a little while. All right, here we go, South Loop.
Man, this shot is going on way too long, especially considering how poorly composed it is. Of the terrible focus. Oh, there's a flat-backed millipede.
Well, that's the trail.
This shot is not interesting, either. Did a lot of this kind of stuff in the old days.
Well, I made it to the first camping area. This is always a good sign.
Ha! Oh, skinny my legs look. I did not have my backpacking muscles yet.
So I'm taking a breather here at the first camp. It's a nice little camp area. And the nicest thing about it is that there's no one here.
Here you can see me writing some notes. This is something I do on some of my trips. Especially now that I narrate my videos. I have a little notebook I carry with me on my trips. You can occasionally see me writing in it in a few different videos. But that's where, you know, a lot of the narration that I do in the videos is actually things that I thought about when I was on the trail. I try to keep it close to the actual thoughts that I had while I was out there. So a lot of times if an interesting phrase or observation crosses my mind, I try to jot it down. Or a lot of times, like around the campfire at night, I'll sit down and write some things down. So that's what I'm doing there, even though I did not do narration for this one.
One of the cool things about the campgrounds, or the campsites here, is that they have their own restroom.
It is a good thing.
Well, there's nobody in it. And you might want to bring your own toilet paper. But hey, it's a thing to sit on and shit on.
Now this was before I decided to make my channel PG rated. I don't really even know why I originally did that. I think I just wanted to, I didn't want to alienate any part of the audience. I wanted to make it family friendly. Which I think I'm glad that I did. There's not really any reason for me to include my swearing in my videos, but I think there's a little bit of it in this. Nowadays I have to bleep that stuff out. Actually, I don't bleep it out. I very meticulously edit it out of the audio track.
These beetles are flying all over the place. Not sure what kind they are. They look a little bit like an elater. Like part of the click beetle family.
Ooh, this would be a decent shot if the autofocus wasn't going nuts.
That was a nice break. And I feel good now that I've got those first 3 miles behind me. The trail's a little muddy up here. And there was a nice campground there. I don't think you'd want to camp more than about 3 parties there, though. Or wait a minute. Actually, I'm not even sure that was the real camp, because now there's a sign up here. Let's check this out. Okay, maybe there's more space than I thought.
Man, that microphone picks up all the wind.
There are 3 guys back there that came up to that campsite where I was sitting. I'm not sure where they're going to spend the night, but kind of look like they might be done for the day. But I'm going to move on. The next thing on the trail is Campground 2, which is about 4.4 miles from here. Oh, here's another hill.
So, I find this vlog-style talking head stuff to be really boring. there's a good reason I don't do this kind of stuff in my videos anymore. And part of it is just because I don't really like the way I look and speak on camera. So I don't think I have a very good camera presence. I don't think I have a very expressive face. I don't think I have a very dynamic voice. So I think that listening to me is just kind of boring. And especially when I'm on the trail, I'm always hesitating and stuttering because I'm half out of breath and I just don't know what to say, especially when I turn the camera on myself. But the other thing I don't really like about that is the stuff that I talk about. And you can see a lot of this in my older videos before I started doing the narration thing. But I turned the camera on and pointed at myself, and I would start talking about the temperature and the time and how many hours of light are left in the day and how many miles there are until the next trail intersection or the next water source and the name of the trail and the name of the trail that I'm going to intersect with in 1.7 miles or whatever. And the reason that I talk about that stuff on the trail is because that's the kind of stuff you're thinking about on the trail. That's you have to think about that kind of stuff. That kind of becomes your life when you're on the trail. But to me, like it's that to me that's not interesting to anybody who's not on the trail at that moment. Even looking back on my own trips, as soon as they're over, I don't care about all that little trail tedium anymore. Like I don't care that there were 2.7 more miles left before camp, and there's 3 hours of light left, and I'm getting pretty tired, and I'm running low on water. I just don't care anymore. And rewatching my old videos really made that obvious to me how much I think that kind of stuff just doesn't matter. And that's why a lot of the narration that I do now is more about how I'm feeling and what the experience is actually like to me. Just trying to give some kind of impression of what it was like to actually be there, instead of just like listing off this kind of tedious informational stuff. Now, some people can pull that off really well. I'm not trying to insult anybody else on YouTube who does that kind of stuff. I think some guys are really good at that. I don't think I am. And that's mostly why I don't try to do that kind of stuff anymore. Now, with that said, I have had a few requests to do another video where I talk to the camera. So I might do that in the future, but I want to do it in a little bit different way. And I don't know how to do that yet. So maybe someday we'll see another one of those. That's a typical Chad move there. So that walking stick that I'm using is the walking stick I always used to use before I got into using trekking poles. It's a walking stick that my dad gave me that I think was carved by a friend of his from a root of a tree. I'm not
So,
sure which kind of what kind of tree.
why the video?
Yeah,
You may
why?
be wondering.
I'm kind of wondering that too.
Well, mostly it's because I've been addicted to backpacking videos on YouTube. And
That's it.
I thought I'd try my hand at my own and see what happens. But I do plan on writing a blog post about this too. I just wanted to see how it turned out. And also, since I'm doing this solo, and I know that there's not a lot of scenery other than the woods, which is nice, but not a lot of overlooks or anything like that, I thought it might keep me occupied and entertained. And it's doing that so far.
It does do that, actually. Especially on a solo trip, it's really nice to have the camera with you. It kind of keeps you company, keeps you from getting lonely, even when you're not
Okay then.
talking at it.
See, the terrain is definitely changing. It's sandier. There's pines. Well, I said there wouldn't be any nice views, but there's actually a couple really nice views up here.
Some wild roses.
Well, I'm back in the interior now, and it's getting hot and muggy and buggy down here. But there was another nice view up there, a cliff under the pines. But those three guys that I've seen all day, they were camped out there. Also up there, you can apparently look down where the Moonville Tunnel is, and you can see the lantern of the ghost that haunts the tunnel. He was supposedly killed trying to flag down a train waving a lantern, and you can still see his lantern waving in the dark. Good place to camp.
Now that's the kind of stuff that actually I enjoy. Man, look at my face right now. That's the kind of stuff that's actually worth saying to the camera, as opposed to all of that little trail minutia stuff.
I'm about halfway between Camp 1 and Camp 2 right now.
Like this kind of crap.
I think I'm going to have to call it quits at Camp 2. I was sort of hoping to walk a little bit more than that. But after Camp 2, the next camp is about 6 or 7 miles. And I don't think I can do another 6 or 7 miles after I get there. Plus, it's going to be getting late. It's probably going to be about 4 o'clock by the time I get to Camp 2. But it's getting pretty treacherous now. I'm going to put away the camera so I don't slip and fall. I think when I get to the bottom of whatever I'm climbing down to, there's a swamp there. And then after the swamp, I'm going to have to climb all the way back up to the ridgetop where the camp is.
You know, the stabilization is actually pretty good on that little camera.
This would have been a nice place to filter some water, but this creek bed is bone dry. There is nothing in here. Man, it is a much different environment down here than it is up there, where I was with the overlooks. Bugs in my eyes. Just millipedes crawling around. Bugs flying in my eyes right now. And very humid. Coming out of the hollow now. And good thing too. It's nasty down there. And for a little while I thought maybe I got off the trail somehow, because I stopped seeing the orange blazes. Earlier in the day, those orange blazes were on every other tree. Look up and see 6 of them ahead of you. But for a while back there, I didn't see any. But I figured there must be only one trail that goes through that hollow. There's not really a way for multiple trails to even fit through there. Well, here's the water. Oh, yeah, look at that. I don't know if I'd drink that.
Yeah, I would. I would now. If I had to. It's clear. It's got algae in it.
Wetland. Wet trail.
See my camera, my shadow.
Jeez, these lizards are scaring me. Scaring the crap out of me.
Because I thought they were snakes, I guess.
See this one.
A pretty little guy, a little five-lion skink.
No, I really feel like I'm out in the middle of nowhere. Which I suppose I sort of am. You can hear frogs, woodpeckers out here.
I don't think I hear any frogs.
And perhaps you can hear the sound of my good battery dying. Sort of killing my battery. I have 2 spares, but they're both not very good. Lizards just everywhere out here. You might be able to tell. This trail's kicking my ass.
I can tell.
I must be out of shape, because this 4-point...
Shit.
This 4.4 miles feels like about 8.
Oh no, here we go. Here comes another trail sequence with copyrighted music that I need to talk over. Just look how hilariously terrible this is. Why did I do this? I don't understand why I thought this was a good idea.
Yeah, the two exist. There's a few sites here. There's two of them already taken. This one looks like mine.
The wind noise is just driving me crazy. That's probably why I never uploaded this.
I kind of suspect I might be sharing it with somebody, but I'm going to claim my corner right now. I'm going to be right here.
Another skink. Oh, I did some... I should have cut the audio on this. I used to love these kind of sequences. You can probably see... There's a couple other of these on my channel. But for some reason, I didn't cut out the audio. And the sped-up audio sounds really weird. Also, this was before I knew about free YouTube music. So other than the music that's in the copyrighted music...
In a different spot.
No music in this video.
I had trouble finding a flat spot. Got my air mattress blown up. My Enlightened Equipment quilt is in there, lofting up. It's my first time using that.
Oh, cool.
In the field, anyway. I've used it at home.
I didn't realize that was my first trip with the Enlightened Equipment quilt. I've had that longer than I thought, I guess. I also was using the Nemo Tensor sleeping pad in there that I really wanted to like that pad, but I never had much luck with it. It had multiple holes, and I just never could get that comfortable on it. I'm not sure why. Everybody else seems to really love those pads, so it's probably just me. But I started sleeping much better after I switched over to a Therm-a-Rest.
And here's my camp. I'm really going to have to conserve battery life now, because my backup batteries aren't even working at all. Camera won't even turn on with them.
You know, that's actually a tricky thing. Figuring out the battery life situation takes a little while. And now I've used, I think, three different cameras plus my phone camera on the channel now. So every time I've tried a new camera, I've had to learn how long a battery lasts and how many I need to bring with me and if I need to bring a charger with me and, you know, what to do about off-brand batteries that usually don't last as long as the official batteries. Clearly, I did not do a very good job of that on this trip, because this is like I've barely recorded anything and I'm already running out of battery life.
I got a nice view. I've gotten very, very tired of north sides and instant potatoes.
Oh.
So I brought a couple different things this time.
Oh, the jet boil.
I got that going.
That's not much better than a north side. Basically the same thing.
We got some spam in there.
For some reason I thought...
instant mac and cheese. Ramen. I do have the potatoes in there still, but...
I didn't do a very good job of...
I'm gonna eat them.
I didn't do a very good job of not bringing north sides and mashed potatoes, because...
Go into survival mode. Get me some electrolytes. And B vitamins.
Out of focus. Is there a single good shot in this video? I don't think there is. Everything's out of focus. Everything is shaky. Nothing is well composed. This actually makes me feel better about my recent videos.
I'm quite dark, but I'm in bed. I'm worn out. The bugs are bad out there. My fire's died down, so I'm just going to lay in bed and watch the sky get dark as I fall asleep. Good night.
What a terrible transition. Oh.
My morning view.
That was awful. of frozen frame.
It's about 6:30.
Jeez, that looked rough.
Got a little chilly last night. I'm glad I had this quilt. Got a nice view of the sunrise.
Looked like I slept very well. Oh, I remember putting this long sequence in here. Long sequence of me stuffing that quilt into that bag because I was fascinated with how compact you can make a down quilt. I still am kind of fascinated by that. It's kind of amazing. The size of a quilt or a sleeping bag that you can cram into a tiny little thing like that. You should see my new one. Just wait till you see the new one that I got. You're not going to see it until a deep winter trip, but man, this thing is huge, and it packs down into a shockingly small size. I think that's really staked down. I didn't even need to stake it in at all. Man, that's one of the things I miss about that Kelty tent.
Found some extra battery life.
Hold on, we gotta talk about the Kelty tent really quick. So one of the things I like about, well, a freestanding tent like that is that you can just pick it right up and shake it out, and you don't have to sweep it or anything like that. That Kelty tent still gets used. I've had that thing for almost 10 years. And, you know, I have my nice lightweight tarp tent now that I, you know, is my primary tent. But that Kelty still gets used. In fact, I used it earlier this year in a trip that I did not make a video of, but I believe you can see it on another channel, perhaps Bluegrass Backcountry or Smoky Bees Natural. I think you can see the Kelty tent this year. But I don't think a year has gone by where I haven't used it at least one time. Great little tent. If you want a beginner backpacking tent that costs like, maybe $120 or somewhere around there, that will last a long time, I think that's the best budget option for a backpacking tent. And they make a bunch of similar ones.
So, there might be video today. I'm just packing up now. Got all my stuff over there. My tent's drying over there. The bottom was kind of wet.
I don't know why I did that.
And
I'm leaving today.
I'm gonna go brush my teeth. I slept all right last night. Camp sleep, anyway. It was kind of nice going to bed with the sunset and waking up with the sunrise. Lots of animal sounds in the night. Whippoorwills, of course, and
Nick's favorite
frogs from down in the hollow somewhere. And I heard an owl last night too, really close, really loud. And this morning I got up and I already made my breakfast and I ate. I'm going to drink some more water here because there's no more water sources. Actually, there's not even a water source back at the car, so whatever I pack out of here is going to have to last me the rest of the hike anyway. Well, I just left camp and hit the trail. And starting the day off right with a nice steep hill. Kind of dark down here still. It's a little bit after 8 o'clock. I think I'm the first one from the camp to leave today, so it might be a lonely day on a trail. Oh, spider webs.
I think it was.
Yeah, I'm the first person out
lonely
here.
Day. I don't think I saw anybody else.
Goes. My legs are a little stiff. But
on the trail this day.
After this nice warm up here, I'll be feeling better. I've got a pretty good walk today, almost as far as yesterday. Trail's a little bit muddy today.
It's a lot muddy.
I already got a wet foot. We're in a hollow right now. It didn't rain or anything. But let's see if I can get through here without falling in. Oh man, it's really wet. Right now I'm walking alongside this really steep, deep creek bed. I can't even see the bottom of it. I don't know if there's water down there or not. There probably is. It's no wonder there were so many mosquitoes up in camp. This is a mosquito wonderland down here. And I'm sure they're thrilled with all that warm blood up top. This is a really cool trail though.
But it doesn't look... Oh, there's a cool millipede. You know, it didn't do a very good job showing that it was a cool-looking trail, though. And I think that's one of the things I really failed at doing in some of my older videos is figuring out how to capture the way that it felt. Capture the scale of things and the... you know, well, just anything like that, the scale of things and the feeling of things and the scope of things. And that's one of the things I've really focused on doing with a lot of my other videos and just trying to, like, figure out how to compose shots that make it feel like you're actually there, that really give you an impression of how high up you are, how, you know, what kind of elevation you're at, or how deep inside a cave you are, or those kind of things. And I think I've gotten better at it, but man, I was not good at that kind of thing in this video.
Burn area here. Probably gonna be a lot of sun up here. It's pretty hot already. Well, I'm near the top now. There's a nice breeze. But it must have been pretty recent. You can still...
Here, I want to say something else. So, about the whole talking to the camera thing. Another thing is that I've really adopted the show, don't tell thing that is kind of a advice that... it's like amateur writer advice, you know, advice that's given to beginning writers. Is, you know, show me, don't tell me. And I think that's one of the issues I have with the talking head thing in my videos, is that instead of showing you how it felt, I'm telling you how it felt. I'm telling you that it's hot. Instead of just letting the video show it, look, I mean, you can see me sweating. So I don't need to tell you that it's hot. You can tell it's hot. I'm sweating like crazy. So I try to do that in my videos now too. So instead of telling you that it's cold, I show you that it's cold. You know, show that my water is freezing in my water bottle. Show that our breath is fogging. Show that we're all bundled up, or you know, show that we're tired. You know, that you don't have to say that it was a long day on the trail. You can make the viewer feel it by your choice of shots and the way that you edit it and the way that you compose your shots and the music that you use. So I've really taken that to heart with my newer videos too. I try to show instead of tell.
Smell the charred trees.
Now the smell of the charred trees is something that you might not be able to show. That's a good candidate for narration. Or like this shot is supposed to be me climbing uphill, but you can't tell that I'm climbing uphill. And I think it was pretty steep, if I remember correctly.
Following an old road.
So like nowadays, I would find a way to
old gravel road
make it feel like I'm climbing a steep hill.
I was just thinking about how one of the things that I love the most about being in the woods is how rejuvenating it is. Whenever I go out, spend the night in the woods, and wake up and go back out in the morning, it's like a little rebirth. You kind of shake off all the rust that you've been accumulating in your daily routine. And it makes me look at everything with fresh eyes when I get back. Kind of reinvigorates my interest in everything too. I'm more interested in reading and more interested in writing. Not to mention it gives you an appreciation for a hot shower and a clean place to eat your dinner. And a real dinner.
Okay, that wind noise was terrible again, but okay, so what I was just talking about there, that's actually a good use of talking to the camera. You know, I'm talking about what it feels like and you know, what my internal experience of backpacking is like. And that's also a theme that has been repeated many times on my channel and in the old blog that I used to keep that I mentioned a while back. The sense of rejuvenation that you get in the woods and the sense of appreciation and gratitude that you have for all of the marvels of modern society when you come back from not having them for several days, not having a hot shower, not having a microwave, not having a washer and a dryer and a refrigerator. And I've talked about that a number of times, probably too many times in my videos, but that's something that I think is worth talking about. That's like if I'm going to talk to the camera, it should be about that kind of stuff.
Look at the way this tree's growing. Or was growing, it's dead.
See, the stabilization's actually not that bad on that camera. I mean, that could have looked a lot worse.
We found the caves. Although they're not really caves, they're rock shelters. Taking a break in the cave. There's a fire pit in here and some nice logs to sit on. So I'm gonna take a break and have a snack. Well, I can tell you which way I'm not going. I've got about 3.5 miles to go, and I'm now battling battery life and limited space on my SD card, so there's not going to be a whole lot of video from here on out, but quite a bit of what I'm going to see is stuff I've already done anyway. I'm going to be backtracking for a couple miles at the end.
Kind of a lollipop trail.
I don't think there's going to be much to see.
Lollipop route. There's some neat stuff on that trail. The rock shelters are cool. This is actually a halfway decently composed shot. I mean, it doesn't look great because of the exposure, but probably the best one we've seen in this video. Oh no, here comes the music again. All right, we gotta talk over it. We gotta talk over this music so that YouTube doesn't hit me with a copyright strike. I don't want to be demonetized, even though I'm probably never going to monetize either my channel or this particular video. Oh no, and here comes another one of these terrible map sequences. What am I doing? I'm like, why didn't I cut that part out? I just do not understand that whatsoever. All right, see, we got a lollipop kind of trail, and we're going to complete it, and then we're going to go all the way back down to the Hope Schoolhouse parking lot, and that was really loud.
You missed some of the best scenery on the whole hike.
I don't know what I'm going to... I got to do something about that.
Gulches and creeks. Kind of look like Hocking Hills for a little while. And Hocking Hills actually isn't far from here. You also missed the cute little snake that tried to bite me. But what you didn't miss...
Random still in there.
...is the end of the trail.
Hey!
Parking lot's empty except for my car. Now I'm going to go home and get a hamburger and some strawberry shortcake. And maybe start editing this video. Well, thanks for watching the video and sorry if it's a mess.
Yeah, sorry. Sorry indeed. I am sorry that it was a mess. Okay, well, that was fun. I hope everybody enjoyed that little little glimpse into the past of Beyond the Campfire. Yeah, pretty terrible video, but you know, actually, I don't think it's that much worse than the first couple videos that are on the channel now. So I don't know why I didn't release this in the first place. Maybe it was because of the music and I didn't want to get a copyright strike. Maybe it was because of that awful wind noise. I don't really know, but for whatever reason, I didn't release it until now. So now it's out there. This has kind of gone on long enough. I should probably wrap this up, but that was kind of fun. Let me know. Leave me a comment if you liked this and want to see something like this again, because it would be kind of fun to go through and do commentaries on some of my old videos. I think I would like that. I also might have some other unreleased stuff. I don't have any other videos like this, but I have some unreleased footage from a couple other trips that never quite made it into video form, and I could like throw something together really quick and walk through those. But yeah, that's it. Thank you again for watching. Thank you everybody who has subscribed and gotten me to 1,000. Thank you Samuel for suggesting this video. Thank you Nick for helping me get to that 1,000. Yeah, I don't have anything else to say, so I'll see you guys later.